In this episode, we will cover the minimal TLS version setting that is new and available in Azure SQL Database. Join us in Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. I'm Anna Hoffman, and today I'm joined by Program Manager Rohit Nayak on the Azure SQL team. Thanks for being with us again today, Rohit.
Thank you, Anna. Happy to be here.
We're happy to have you. And today we're going to be talking about TLS. And this is kind of an ongoing series that we've been doing together, talking about networking and network security. And, you know, I wanted to start today by just asking, you know, what is it and why should us SQL people care about TLS?
Perfect segue into my presentation here. So TLS stands for Transport Layer Security Protocol. And what it does is basically it is used when we log into the SQL database. So viewers should be familiar with this diagram by now, which is I'm showing a client on the left-hand side and our SQL gateway on the right. So the first thing that happens when you try to connect is you have a TCP handshake, and then the client usually sends a pre-login message. This is all standard stuff, which is part of the TDS protocol that we use. Now, within the TDS protocol, we have what is called as a TLS handshake, in which the client basically says, what is the version of TLS that it wants to use while connecting to the server? And then there's this back and forth that happens, and eventually the login to the database goes through. So this is where TLS gets used. Now, as an end consumer of SQL database, why should you care? It's primarily because TLS has multiple versions over the years. And the most secure version that is out there today that we support is TLS 1.2. TLS 1.3 is also in the works, and we are working towards supporting it in the future. But today, what we want is for customers to be able to use the most secure version that we support. And primarily because, like any of the protocols, the older versions have well-known vulnerabilities that make you susceptible to attacks. So that's the whole motivation here for us to give customers the choice to enforce a version of TLS at the server level.
Gotcha.
So here, this is again our demo server that we used even in the previous video. And similar to the deny public network access, we have a minimal TLS version that we allow at a server level. Now, unlike the previous setting, this particular setting you will see is nothing is selected here. And the reason why it is because by default, we allow you to connect with any version of TLS, right? And this is in fact a choice that you're making here by choosing a particular version. So let me just show you what I have a demo set up here, where on a VM, I have a tool that I'm using to connect to my database. So this is a tool called dbeaver. It's an open source tool, but basically what it allows me to do is choose the version of TLS that my driver uses to connect. So here I go choose TLS 1.1, and I say connect. And you can see I'm able to browse the tables and things like that. So nothing new here.
Got it. Now, so with no TLS rule, we're just going to allow you to connect however you want. And that's kind of what you just showed us.
Correct. And this is how things are today, if there's nothing selected here. Now let's make things interesting. I go and I enforce TLS 1.2, which is the most secure version of TLS that we support today. And if I flick back to my VM and just try to disconnect and reconnect. Okay, so here's the error that I got. Login failed with invalid TLS version. So we have refined this error message a little bit, and in the latest version, it'll actually say that the client tried to connect with a TLS version that is lesser than what is enforced on the server. So which is exactly what happened here, where the client was trying to connect with 1.1 and it was denied. And now I'm going to go edit the connection, go to the driver properties and change this to 1.2. And again, I try to connect and my connection is going through. So that is in a sense a very simple demo of how this feature works, which is it enforces a TLS version on the server, and any clients trying to connect with lesser versions, namely 1.0 or 1.1, will get rejected with an explicit error message.
I see. Thanks, Rohit. Now, if I'm a user or, you know, organizing this server or managing this server, and I want to make sure all my applications and my users are still able to connect as I go towards 1.2, is there a lot that I'm going to need to do?
Yes. So in the coming months, we are going to expose some telemetry so that customers get to know first as a customer before setting this button to 1.2, you want to be very certain that none of your clients are using the lower protocols. So right. We are working on customer-facing telemetry through the portal and through audit logs that will land in the next month or two. So that will give you visibility so that once you set this button, then you are totally confident that you are there's no clients are being disconnected because of this. And the other thing to note is once I set this, there's no going back. Like I can't uncheck this and go back to the previous state. So that is why we will give you the telemetry so that you can make an informed choice. And of course, as customers, you can transition to using different versions. So if your applications are only supporting 1.0, you can start at the extreme lower end of the spectrum and then keep working your way up. So that's where we give you the flexibility to work with different versions. And then eventually, we would like you to be at this state where you are on the most secure version of TLS.
Awesome. Thanks, Rohit. So this has been really useful. It seems like overall, we're trying to get our customers to the most secure configuration, but we're kind of here to help, and we're not going to force you. And we're also going to try to help you understand who's connecting with those lower versions so they don't get disconnected. I personally think this was a great session. I learned a few things. And so thanks for being here, Rohit. And we'll provide some links in the description for you to go learn more. And please like and subscribe to our channel if you're interested in learning more about Azure SQL. See you next time on Data Exposed.